we are doing chisa, but not like this. Not rolling the hands. 1,000 years you can keep rolling the hand, you'll never know how to fight with a guy. But that was structured. If you want to learn how to fight using chisa, you need to do unstructured chisa. Nobody in the street is going to come when you're fighting the guy. You say, hey, come on, roll hands with me. Join the hands with me. Nobody's going to join hands with you. The guy will come with a big sweep punch. Beam, go for a takedown. And you're off. You want to stand like this? Where does the wing chun go? Dustbin. You need to understand structure. You need to understand the structure. Don't follow the movies, stand like it, man, you know. The days have gone. You keep yourself covered. Keep your guard, keep the triangle on. Because if the guy swings right away, you move, you push the guy right away. But if he swings and he goes for a double leg takedown, you move guard. Oh, see, look at this. My structure, look at the triangle right away. He wants to clip inside. Oh, okay, I'm gonna move. Okay, break this one right away. You see, I disbalance the structure right away. And then use your chong choy. You must understand the reality of why we do Wing Chun. That's why I'm not gonna be shooting my punches out of it. Wing Chun works only in close proximity. What if the guy is here? You know, you can't follow, keep following the guy like this. I'm not trying to hurt anyone's feeling, but I'm talking about reality. Because there's so much mayhem, so much pressure. Variety of the punches are coming from a variety of angles. You must understand how to train. Train free. Free chisa. Chisa has four positions. If he punches me, I punch him back. This is one position of chisa. He punches me from right, I punch him. This is another position. Grabs. Tell him I come here. Two hands up. This is chisa. And this is chisa. Free chisa is, I let him do what he wants to do to me and I respond and react. Right now I'm not going to be using any punches, but just to understand the energy. Okay, move. Fight is over. Yeah. So this is hard training, this is active training. What you have to do is find a right teacher for yourself. Very, very important. I'm giving you three things in martial arts. You have to believe. First, know yourself. Second, know your enemy. When you know yourself, you know your abilities. You know your weakness. Know your enemy. The biggest enemy is you. You got a big head. You think you are some champion with, you know, 20 times national champion or nothing against that. That is martial sports. I'm talking about street where the guy is there to kill you, to fight with you. He's gonna bust your head with that iron pipe. You need to train differently. So you need to know your weakness. You yourself are the biggest enemy of yourself. Number three, like Shifu Yanzi, my teacher says, don't be sluggish in training. You goddamn train every day and train hard. Train on your basics more, on your structure, on your angle. Train on your strike. Make your hands strong, make your body strong. Number four, very, very important, is to fight a right teacher. Stick with him. Have five girlfriends, you have a problem. Stick with one. Tell that teacher to teach you everything. Once the teacher has taught you everything, he himself will say, you need to move on. Once you have a breakup, then only you go to another one. You find another one to live with that person. It's your choice. So you have to make the right choice. Don't start learning jiu-jitsu and taekwondo and Wing Chun like this. People ask me, you know, I do six martial arts. Yes, I do. But I've spent plenty of years mastering one martial arts first, Shaolin, and then went on to learn other systems. People might teach you for money. Here in Shifu Kanishka Combatives and Pigiri Tertia Kali here, we don't train like that. You have to sweat yourself out. You have to bleed. You have to be mentally very strong to be a fighter who will survive out there in the street. This man out here, Agalon Jitendra. He came to me, Kame. He came to me like 85-90 kgs, you know. He has this guy as a heart. He is the official mentor under me for the Indian Special Forces. This guy is training. So is our lover boy Aditya Roy. Agalon Aditya from PTK also. You need to have heart to train, you know. All of you are most welcome to train with us if you have the heart to train. You know, don't come to the dojo and start crying. Oh, I can't do this, you know, my limbs are paining. There are many other teachers for you guys, you know. You got to come here, you got to believe in this. Train like you fight, fight like you train. And we are always there for you. Thank you so much.